Hello children, very good morning to you all. Hope you all understood my lesson. In previous class we chatted about the world of microorganisms and just continuing with it. Let me do the recap of what I have done in my previous class. Now you have learned about what are microorganisms. Now, microorganisms are the organisms which are not visible to our eye. It is only possible to see with the help of a microscope. Now we have learned in the last class the scientist who discovered the microscope. Okay, his name is, what is his name? Antonio van Leeuwenhoek. He was a person, because of his discovery today we know that there are many microorganisms which are found in the surrounding, everywhere it is found. Not only in water, in the air, in the soil, everywhere we find these microorganisms. Today I will recap whatever we have learned in the previous class. We have learned about the different types of bacteria. Okay, you can see these are the different types of bacteria. And have done the next you can see is these are the different types of bacteria which you find in the atmosphere, in the nature. Then you find these are the different types of algae, Chlamydomonas, example Chlamydomonas, Spirogyra. And then you find different group, that is the protozoans. In this you find amoeba and paramecium. These are the protozoans which you find in the water, mostly you find them. Then next you find these are the different types of fungi. Okay, this fungi you can see using a magnifying glass. This is which is the bread mold which you find on the bread, which I have explained to you in the last class, which can be seen with the magnifying glass also. If you want to see the spores, you need the microscope. These are the penicillium and these are the other example of aspergills. Then other than that, these are the, compared to other organisms, these are micro, very tiny organisms which you need a highly magnifying microscope, electronic microscope you require to observe these organisms. Now we have to do the activity to find all these organisms where it is found. Okay, now for this activity too, you have to take some sample of water. For this you need to write the aim, the materials and the procedure, and your observation you should write in your notebook. Is it clear to you, children? Now let us do the activity. For this activity you need to take some sample of cold water. Okay, and then you have to take a watch glass, place this water in the pond, the collected cold water in the watch glass, then with the help of a dropper place it on a slide. Okay, and make use of a cover slip to place it carefully, and then place it under the microscope. When you place it under the microscope, you can see the organisms which I showed you in the previous class or just now which I showed you. Is it clear to you? So with this we can know that there are different types of organisms present in water. You have placed the drop under the microscope, you can see the lens. Okay, so I have placed the cold water on the slide under the microscope. Now when you see, you can see the organisms which are present in the cold water. There are around 10 million species of microorganisms in the world. You can see the different organisms, the algae, the fungi, and then different organisms you can see. Bacteria, protozoa, fungi and algae. So these are the organisms which you can observe under the microscope. If you see the nature, you can see the virus, the bacteria, all these are the microbes which are present in the air. Then not only in the air, even in the fresh water also you find some of the microorganisms like cyanobacteria, protozoans and the ciliates. Then these are the habitat of different microorganisms. You can see this here, you can see the organisms like fungi, terrestrial microbes. Then underwater also you find microorganisms. Okay, so this is how the organisms are spread all around. This means the organisms are present everywhere. Now you can see bacteria and microbial eukaryotes. All these are underwater also you find. Not only you find these organisms on the body of the animals and humans contain variety of microorganisms. So that is the reason we need to be very careful. Now if you observe under the magnifying glass, your hand is also filled with different types of microorganisms. That is the reason we are asked to sanitize your hands nowadays. Understood? Now you find even the teeth. You know, in the class I explained how the bad smell comes. It's all because of the microorganisms. So you find here also your eyes will be affected by different kinds of diseases. It is also due to microorganisms. Now this is the reason, the latest disease you are affected is respiratory diseases. You know, this virus enter into different parts of the body and it will totally damage our organs. That's why we need to take care of our health. We need to sanitize ourselves, all these things. So that is the reason we use mask at present. Understood? So each and everybody has to take the hygienic conditions whatever is described. Now let us take this bread. You have got two types of organisms. One is useful, one is harmful. Useful or make use of yeast, which is used for making the bread. And these are pathogenic bacteria. It's nothing but which cause disease in us. Okay. So with this, I complete the lesson. And in the next class, I'll continue with the remaining activity. Thank you, children. Have a nice day.